Hey, pork pie, it's you.
I sit at home waiting for my fate. No telephone and a sink full of dirty plates. It's Saturday night, I've got no license and I'm watching TV. When suddenly, I've got the money.
Done this before?
I used to do it all the time.
Not with me, you didn't.
Oh, I had my reasons.
So what's my reason then?
Michael, it's Valentine's Day, the day of love, romance, scented candles, whipped cream.
TV in bed?
Yes, yes, TV in bed. I'll do it.
No, I'll do it.
Are you sure?
No.
Hello, Lucy. It's Mandy Ambrose here. Michael can't come in today. He's got a furry tongue. No, I mean it's swollen. His throat. I mean it's sore. Yes, that's it. He's got a sore throat. And you can't have a bank manager who can't talk, now can you? No, it's not that bad. He'll definitely be in tomorrow. Yes. Thanks, Lucy. Bye.
I told you I should have done it. She's never going to believe that.
Michael, you're the boss. She's paid to believe it.
Yeah.
Love is in the air.
What's all this, Leonie? How come everything red?
It's Valentine's Day, Mr. Porkpie.
So what happened to the peanut butter?
Mr. Porkpie, today is the day of love.
Love? What do you know about love?
Where?
I've had more love than a Mills and Boone heroine.
Is it?
I'm talking real love. You know the saying, it's better to have loved than lost than never to have loved at all?
Yes.
Well, I wish I'd never met her in the first place.
Oh, you mean,
Susu, the most beautiful woman I've ever met. Not just beautiful on the outside, but on the inside, too. Just like a ripe mango. She's kind, thoughtful, generous, so many nice qualities. I just can't begin to list them. And when she left, she took them all with her.
Ah, and a piece of you, too, by the looks of things.
Yes. Anyway, for me, Valentine's Day is too commercial, just like those deodorant advertisements. You know, they tell you if you put your arm up, you'll stink the place out. So you go and get a deodorant to stop that happening. Only now, when you put your arm up, you stink of musky things from some rainforest somewhere. So all you've done is replace one stink with another.
So you're saying that Valentine's Day stinks?
Yeah.
Okay. But to me, it smells like candlelight dinner for two. Followed by dancing to sweet boy Sylvester Sola sounds. Oh. Ooh, look at this.
For me?
Yes.
But there's no name on it.
That's the whole point. You have a secret admirer. Someone out there fancies you, and now you have to find out who it is. Love is in the air.
This is Benji's Bar. We arrange parties, weddings, funerals, and bar mitzvahs. Whenever drinks are needed, you are guaranteed to get drunk with us or your money back.
Oh, it's you. No, I told you, the check's in the post, darling.
Yeah.
Who was that?
Your wife.
What? It's all right, she's not looking for you. She just wants payment for last week's supply of patties and jerk chicken. Oh,
she trusts no one, that woman.
Especially you.
Hey, looking good in here, Benji.
Thanks, Harry. So how's things?
Well, they'd be a lot better if I won that weekend in Paris. What do I have to do for that? Is it a raffle or what?
It's my latest brainwave. It's a cocktail.
What's a cocktail?
Win a weekend in Paris. It's a cocktail. Panthers all flocking. It's marketing, mate. It's the first time we've done cocktails here. It will draw their eyes to it.
Wait a minute. Isn't that illegal?
No. It's a cocktail. I haven't said you can win a weekend in Paris. I just said win a weekend in Paris.
So what's in it?
I don't know. I haven't made that one up yet.
But what about a pretty woman?
Yes, please!
So, Benji, how many Valentine cards did you get?
Oh, loads. I sent an extra postman this morning.
Really?
Yeah, I got two.
Any idea who they're from?
No, but between you, me and the optics, I'd like to find out, because I'm feeling a little bit frisky. Did you get any?
Yes, I did. First one ever. I had to get out and sneak it away from the wife.
Oh. Here, it's scented. Now, I'm an expert on scents. Oh, this is a young one. 32. D. Fit, nubile, and definitely Scottish.
How do you know she's from Scotland?
It's got Edinburgh on a postmark. So she signed it?
Yes, she signed it.
So who's it from?
The wife. I might have known. She's got a sister in Edinburgh.
Oh, that's a cruel trick to play on a man.
That's nothing compared to what she did on my birthday.
Michael, darling, Henny Penny's ready for her foxy loxy.
Oh, Henny Penny.
Would Foxy Loxy like a little peek?
Yes, he would, Henny Penny.
Oh!
I could go as a toast. To
twins.
Perhaps I should just check in with the office.
Now, Michael, you know we said this was going to be our special day and how wonderful it would be to conceive on Valentine's Day.
Maybe we should just watch a little television whilst we wait for the aphrodisiac to work. It's fun. A whole day, no distractions.
Yes, isn't there anything else on?
But I like Richard and Judy.
I do. Yes, it's just that... I got us some videos to get us in the mood. Foxy Loxy.
Baby's day out. Three men and a baby. She's having a baby.
Here you are, Doris. That's your third 9.5 weeks. After this, you probably will see Mickey Rourke sitting naked at your table.
Benji, give everybody a drink.
Whoa! Oh, no. Doris, are you sure? Well, what's the occasion, then? You haven't won the again, have you?
No, it's better than
Really?
Keep him coming, Benji.
Hey, Harry, what's wrong? It's Valentine's Day, the day of love.
You got a Valentine's card.
So what's the problem? Was it from the tax man?
Worse than that.
From his wife.
Well, that's a cruel trick to play on a man.
That's nothing, apparently, to what she did to him on his birthday. So, what are you so happy about?
Nothing.
You got a card, didn't you?
Well, yes.
That's great, Pork Pie.
It certainly wasn't from your wife.
Yeah, but she might be soon.
What do you mean?
Well, I've got to find her, don't I?
No, you don't want to do that, Pork Pie. It's all about mystery.
But you said you wanted to know who yours were from.
No, I didn't, not really. It just spoils the mystery. I mean, how else would I get to Pamela Anderson?
What?
Not just her. I sent cards to the old cast of Baywatch. Well, just the women, that is. No, you see, the old point of Valentine's is that you send a card to a bird so that you don't get a rejection. Unless you don't put a stamp on it, of course.
Then I'm going to find out. I want to find out who mine is from.
No, you don't, Pork Pie. Look what happened to Harry.
You're missing the point, Benji. I want to find out before I'm too old to care.
Well, don't give it to Benji for a sniff test.
I'm not even going to ask what a sniff test is.
Come on, let's have a look at it. Oh, now, that is a fantastic card, Pork Pie. Whoever got you that has got taste. If she looks anything like that one, I'd like to find her first.
Anything like that, you can have her. She's not my type.
You must be off your trolley.
Just because everything in a skirt is your type doesn't mean it's mine, Benji.
Anything out of a skirt is my type, actually.
Give me another pretty woman, Benji.
Yes, please!
I'll have a weekend in Paris. What's that?
It's a blinding idea. Do you like it?
How much is it going to cost me?
Well, same as it would cost to buy a love potion number 9.5 weeks, winner takes all, and do you know the way to San Jose? They're cocktails, Pork Pie.
Have a weekend in Paris, then. Hold on, hold on. You sent me this card, didn't you?
No. No, why would I want to do a thing like that? I mean, do I look like a bird to you? I mean, I like your Pork Pie, but that's pushing it a bit.
Benji!
All right, I did. But I sent it to you in good faith. You've been so miserable lately, I just wanted to cheer you up.
Well, I was happy being miserable.
Well, nothing's changed, has it? Don't hit me on my good side. Here.
me one of those.
Ambrose resident.
That's you.
Sorry, wrong number.
Hello, that voice.
Mr. Porkpie, I really think you should eat something. You've been drinking too much.
And I think you should drink something. You've been eating too much.
Anyhow, you're sick. It's me and you tonight.
Give me another pretty woman.
Yes, please.
Porkpie, I've got some bad news from Jamaica.
How bad?
Very.
It's Susu, isn't it?
Yes.
Upstairs.
In the spare room?
I haven't seen Susu for 5 years. What do you think?
Well, I'll leave him here.
Just put them in the bedroom.
But why? Are you sure you want me to stay?
Then I couldn't put you in a hotel, could I?
Damn right.
Susu, my love, my darling.
My stomach. Is what happened to the sandwich? What's wrong with them? I don't want no squiggly-shaped sandwich. And this bread is too thin. It's sliced bread, that's how it comes.
Well, I want unsliced bread.
Sandwiches are made with sliced bread, that's why they're called sandwiches.
But look at my crosses.
Porkpie, where you get this girl from?
She's St. Lucian.
Small Island, that explains it.
And you're Jamaican?
Yes.
Nuff said.
Glory!
Apologize to Susu.
Miss Susu, to you.
Of course it is. But hey, I'm only the maid.
And don't you forget it.
Oh, Susu.
So, Porkpie.
How did you get through immigration? Why don't they put a mark in your passport when you're deported?
Now, you don't worry about that, Porkpie. Isn't it enough I'm here now?
Of course it is. But I just don't want them taking you away again.
Well, don't worry, Porkpie. I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, you're staying for good, then.
Yes, if you promise to make an honest woman of me.
So we still engaged?
Yes.
Porkpie, I've got to get back to the center. I told Michael and Mandy I'd only be gone a few minutes. I'll leave you two lovebirds to it. Nice meeting you, Susan.
You can go. I got some errands for you to run.
I don't run errands, I run a bar.
But I need some help to dear.
Leonie will help you.
Sort it, ta-da.
If a woman make a sandwich like that, I don't want her help.
Thank God for that.
Yeah! Hello, Susu. Let me help you.
Sometimes a woman needs to do things on her own, Porkpie.
What's the big secret?
It's not a secret. I want to buy a flat.
You want to buy a flat?
Mm-hmm.
So why? Don't you want to live here?
Not until we're married, Porkpie. It's been a long time, and we need to take things slowly. If I move in now, people will say I only want you for your money. I've got some of my own. I don't need yours. How much did you win?
This is all head, sir.
So sorry, sir. He's new here. I'll pour you another one.
I'd like a pretty woman.
Yes, please.
This is a bar, not a brothel. Mandy, what's Benji be doing in here?
It's one of his Valentine's Day cocktails.
Oh, right. Sorry, sir. I'm sorry, sir. Of course we can have a pretty woman.
Yes, please.
One moment, sir. Mandy, what's in it?
I don't know. Look in the book.
Mandy, I can't find it.
Well, try looking under P.
Mandy, I can't find it. One moment, sir.
Well, maybe.
You sure?
Well, you're just gonna have to.
One pretty woman.
Yes, yes please.
Coming right up.
Jamaica, widowed. 5 years is a long time to be away from the man you love, you know. I know a lot of people would be thinking, I'm only here because of your money. I don't know why people always see me as a bad woman.
Well, I just forget them. They don't understand us. So when did you decide to come?
Last week. I wanted to be here on Valentine's Day. You remember last Valentine's Day, baby?
I've played it over and over again in my mind so many times, the memory scratched.
I love you, Pork Pie. And I want everyone to know that we're getting married for love. So what better day to start than Valentine's Day, eh?
Can we start now?
In a minute.
I've turned down the bed.
And now you're going to walk the dog.
And now I'm going to walk the dog.
But I don't have a dog.
Yes you do.
I'm going. I'm closing the door. I'm gone.
Alone at last, dear Pork Pie. It must be difficult to find a quiet moment when you have money and all them people around you. But I'm gonna change all that.
Change? Change what?
I just want us to have time together.
Oh, Susu, I know you love me because you loved me even before I had any money. And hearing you say all those nice things only makes an old man very happy.
Old? What do you mean old? I hope you're not too old. Because we got the rest of Valentine's Day to go yet.
Shall we start now?
Look, in a minute. Look, I got something to say. I want you to know that I'm a woman of means. I got £50,000. It may not seem like a lot of money to you, but it's a whole heap of money to me. And I have always dreamt of buying a little house in Peckham, England. You got yours, so I still want mine. You understand?
Yes, yes, yes. But how long are you going to live in your little house before you move into mine?
A year?
A what?
No, Pork Pie, I want me space.
Well, a year's a whole heap of space.
Oh, come on, Porky, baby. Let's not argue. Today's a day of love.
Well, can we go upstairs?
So what you waiting for?
Up so some nasty, filthy person can make it dirty, so you have to clean it up again.
Well, if there weren't any nasty, filthy people, you'd be out of a job. Be thankful for small mercies.
Thank you, Benji. That's all I need after Susu making me feel small.
You are small.
I don't trust that woman.
She seemed all right to me.
Every woman seems all right to you. In fact, every woman's a bit of all right to you. But take it from me, a real woman, she's trouble.
So you're a real woman, eh? Prove it.
I would, if you were a real man. You know, I heard Susu say that she has her own money, but you don't need your own money with Pork Pie. And once they're married, what's his is hers.
Not if Michael has anything to do with it. I suppose it is a bit strange that he turns up a few months after he's won the lottery.
Exactly. And what's stranger still is only a week after the West Indian Times article about him winning it.
Could be a coincidence.
Why are you men so gullible when it comes to a pretty woman? Mark my words, Benji. That woman is trouble. You'll be sorry when you find yourself driving her up and down the country. Benji, here. Benji, take me there.
I suppose you could be right. Although she seems to make him happy. All the same, I think we'll keep a close eye on this Susu.
I'd have to keep an eye on her.
Well, you're in control of his finances. He can't do anything unless it goes through you.
That won't stop her.
He's gonna have to. Anyway, let's not worry about that now. It's our day off and there are other things that need taken care of. Ready, Foxy Loxy?
Come in, Henny Penny.
Susu. So good they named you twice.
You're not so bad yourself, old man. What do these young men know, eh?
What young men?
Exactly. Who needs a cub when I got a tiger?
What cubs? Susu, can I be honest with you?
Yes, I'd like you to be honest with me.
Like, I really want to get married this time, but I'm not so sure about this living apart, you know. I mean, a year is a long time. Anything could happen. I am on the wrong side of the hill. I might die.
Oh, Lord, we waited 5 years. What's another year?
6 years. You see, what I don't understand is what you want to do with this year. Why wait?
Porkpie, we gotta wait a year because that's how long the divorce papers will take to come through.
What? But you divorced Maxwell years ago.
It's not Maxwell. It's Henry.
Henry? Who the hell is Henry? You were engaged to me and you're telling me you marry some Henry? And now you want me to wait another year so you marry someone else? You think I'm stupid?
No, Porkpie.
I've loved you from the first time we met, from when we were children. Even Shirley, your own sister, warned me not to be with you. But I listened to no one but my heart and you. You said we would be together, and I believed you. Then you went and married Maxwell. Like a fool, I waited, and on the rebound, I married Gwendolyn. And then there was the fiasco with a toy boy that you tried to marry. And when his mother dragged him from the altar by his ear, I was still waiting. And now you're telling me you married to some Henry?
But I only marry Henry so I could be with you.
How come?
Oh, I only marry Henry so I could get a passport to come and see you.
Really? You did it for me?
I told you before, Porkpie. I love you. I've always loved you.
And I've always loved you. There's just one thing I have to know.
Anything.
Did you sleep with him?
Of course not.
Find out what happens next Thursday night at the same time, 8:30.